We met with virus hunters who go around the world figuring out what's going on and what viruses are hitting in certain spots when people start dying or getting sick.
I'm a field virologist, so my expertise is working in places throughout the world and trying to really examine the interface at which new viruses enter into the human population.
On average, each of these viruses makes one error every time it replicates. So every new virus particle is like a snowflake. It's slightly different than every other virus particle. So if one virus isn't exactly the right virus to jump a species, then maybe the next one, or the next one, or the one after that.
We assumed that viral transmission, or infectious disease transmission in general, was a relatively slowly evolving event.
Viral chatter was a term that I think was coined by Don Burke, who is my mentor at Hopkins. You have this notion of intelligence chatter, and the basic idea being you could monitor communications, and you can look for certain keywords, let's say bomb, for example. You know, often those are going to be complete red herrings and useless. But every once in a while, if you study the systems well enough, you might see the right combination of keywords and the right sort of chatter, if you will, that may indicate to you, okay, well, we better follow this. This may be leading to a terrorist incident or something along those lines. And so the basic idea is quite similar for us. If we study certain human populations, in our case, it's people who are highly exposed to wild animals and other animals, we're gonna see a lot of viral chatter. We're gonna see viruses that are entering these populations, many of which are probably not gonna end up being pandemics. There's probably a tremendous amount of crossover. But the point is, by understanding them and saying, when did these sort of little chatter events lead to something significant, you know, that will help us to really be able to have a system where we can predict and prevent, because that's where we need to ultimately be moving.
They're out there looking. They're trying to see all these viruses that are pinging us to see if they can get across. And I think that's part of what we should be doing for the future.
And so we found a gorilla virus in an individual who reported hunting and butchering of gorillas. That's a very sort of rare thing. And it's pretty much as close as we can get to a smoking gun, that this person acquired this virus associated with hunting and butchering. Now, this kind of contact occurs on a daily basis, on an hourly basis, among thousands, if not millions of people globally, with many different forms of wild animal.
I think one of the most exciting things about what Nathan Wolfe does is mapping what happens to viruses to basically forecast ahead of time what's going to happen with infectious diseases, much the way that we're forecasting the weather.
And the premise that I work under is that a virus like HIV was not inevitable. Think about 2 or 3 years advance notice of what was the agent that caused AIDS, what was the way that it was transmitted, where did it start, where were the genetic variants being established. Had we had this information, we might have drastically changed the course of the epidemic.